हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू लुकमान आईएएस। दिस इज डीटीआरएस सेशन, डेली टक्कर रैपिड सीरीज। इन दिस लेक्चर सीरीज डेली वी आर डिस्कसिंग 10 क्वालिटी एमसीक्यूज बेस्ड ऑन द टुडेज करंट अफेयर्स और द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट डेवलपमेंट्स ऑफ द टुडे। ओके, सो दिस इज क्लास 41। इफ यू वांट टू सी द प्रीवियस क्लासेस यू कैन विजिट लुकमान आईएएस यूट्यूब चैनल एंड यू कैन वॉच इन द प्लेलिस्ट द प्रीवियस सेशंस रिलेटेड टू दिस टक्कर रैपिड सीरीज लेक्चर्स। नाउ टुडेज लीड टॉपिक इज मेकोंग गंगा कोऑपरेशन। Recently there was meeting of this particular international or regional organization, and that's why it is in news. But before going into today's 10 MCQs, let's discuss today's quotation. Daily we are discussing one quotation before discussing these 10 MCQs, and thereafter we are discussing these 10 MCQs. This quotation helps you to understand, interpret the essay topics. Also quotation based questions are asked in the ethics paper, and understanding all these meanings of quotations help in your personality development also. Now today's quotation is by Mahatma Gandhi. In a gentle way you can shake the world. Okay. Yes, and he was true epitome of this quotation himself. Okay, so in a gentle way, let me give you some example. What he is saying through this quotation is, with small actions which are done on consistent basis, these result into large impact, significant impact. This is actually the meaning here. Shake the world means basically the significant positive impact on the larger society, on the more number of people, their lives, betterment of their lives. This is what he is saying. Let's take example. First of all, Mahatma Gandhi's example himself. So if you talk from the sanitation aspect, he was very particular about sanitation, and at that time we know that sanitation was to some extent linked to caste system also, and he was worried about this. And what he used to do is he used to clean the toilets by himself. On daily basis, he used to clean all those toilets in the ashram, and this shows his commitment. अब ये कोई बड़ा action नहीं है ना, बहुत ही मतलब वैसे रास्ते पे उतर के झाड़ू लेके वो नहीं कर रहा है ना, right? Small action, gentle, but through that action he is conveying the message to the people, the importance of sanitation. Now in today's life, if we say how it is relevant, let me give you certain examples. Simple, following laws, rules, regulation. एक simple example लेते हैं traffic rules का, ठीक है? अगर हम daily basis पे हम traffic rules follow करेंगे vehicles, जब भी आप travel कर रहे हैं, तो how it impacts? Simple, gentle way, छोटा सा act है, but yes, it helps in reducing the road accidents, the rash driving that result into road accidents or breaking the signal. दूसरों का mistake नहीं है, but उनकी जो जान है वो जा सकती है. तो basically what we are doing, we are reducing the threat to the people, their lives. Along with that, other example we can take paying taxes. ठीक है, हमारी responsibility है कि हम tax pay करें, but what we are doing, people are evading the tax. And because of that, what is happening? The government is not having resources to help the poor people, needy people. अगर हम time पे tax pay करते हैं सब लोग, जितना है, इतना भी नहीं है ना tax, समझो हम जितना कमा रहे हैं तो उसके हिसाब से तो government थोड़ा ही ले रहा है tax देखा जाए तो. हाँ, जो अमीर होते हैं उनको लगता है कि बहुत tax ले रहा है, क्योंकि आप कमा भी उतना रहे हो ना, ठीक है? आपको लगता है कि और हमारे पास ही रहे. That is not the right approach, and that's why he is saying through gentle way, basically we can change the world. Other example we can take is like, again, cleanliness. In present day context, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan that is being promoted, the behavioral aspects that are being emphasized here, the nudging of behavior is important. Simple. हम क्या करते हैं, हम अगर दिल्ली में रह रहे हो तो आपको पता ही होगा, घर के अंदर इतना क्लीन होगा कि सारा कचरा जो है वो घर का बाहर डाला हुआ रहता है, और बाहर पूरा रास्ता खराब, ठीक है, देखा जाए तो. सो बेसिकली दिस इज नॉट गुड. नो, वी नीड टू ऑल्सो एंश्योर द क्लीनलीनेस ऑफ ऑल द प्रीमाइसेस. दिस इज आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. ओनिंग द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स एंड दिस विल एक्चुअली मेक सिग्निफिकेंट चेंजेस. तो शेक द वर्ल्ड मतलब क्या है कि यहाँ पे पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट ऑन द लार्जर सोसाइटी और द लाइव्स ऑफ द पीपल. दिस इज वॉट वी कैन डू थ्रू फॉलोइंग स्मॉल स्मॉल थिंग्स. जैसे सिविल सर्वेंट्स का अगर एक एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं, सिविल सर्वेंट्स का, तो फॉलोइंग ऑनेस्ट लाइफ इन द सिविल सर्विसेज डेली बेसिस पे आप ऑनेस्ट रहिए ना, आपको कुछ एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट्स थोड़ी करने पड़ रहे हैं, आप ऑनेस्ट रहिए, दिस इज गोइंग टू हैव ह्यूज इम्पैक्ट ऑन द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. ठीक है, आप ऑनेस्ट है तो दूसरे के माइंड पे चेक होता है, आपके नीचे आपके सराउंडिंग वाला हमेशा सोचेगा अरे वो ऑनेस्ट है, वो हमारे हम वो तो कुछ करेगा नहीं, हमको फंसाएगा, तो वो भी करप्शन करने के लिए डरेगा. आर यू गेटिंग दिस? एंड बेसिकली यू आर affecting the larger administration in a positive way. This is what we are trying to say through this quotation. Fine, now you can interpret in a different manner, you can give different examples, and this can be essay topic as well as the question in ethics paper. Okay, fine. So today's 10 topics, right? So we have framed 10 MCQs based on these topics. Let's go in detail of the first one, Mekong Ganga cooperation. Okay, so as the name suggests, Mekong Ganga. Mekong is an important river in the Southeast Asia, and Ganga is important river in South Asia. So simply, it is the cooperation between the Southeast Asian countries and India. Okay, now many a times what happens is students are not able to understand the particular regional body, whether it is political, economic, or strategic, or we can say military alliance. We should understand this is purely in terms of focus in four areas. कौन से areas है वो भी आपको पता होना चाहिए. Tourism, culture, education and transportation. है ना, ये चार इसमें ज़्यादातर कोऑपरेशन होता है, तो आप इसका शॉर्ट फॉर्म बना के याद रखिए. एंड विच आर ऑल कंट्रीज इन्वॉल्व, इंडिया अलॉन्ग विथ म्यांमार, थाईलैंड, लाओस, कंबोडिया, ऑल दीज कंट्रीज ऑफ साउथ एशिया आर पार्ट ऑफ दिस. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट नाउ द स्टेटमेंट्स. इट इज एस्टैब्लिश टू प्रमोट पॉलिटिकल एंड सोशल स्टेबिलिटी अमीड राइजिंग टेंशन अमंग एशिया पैसिफिक पोस्ट कॉलोनियल स्टेट. इसका कोई कॉन्टेक्स्ट ही नहीं है यहाँ पर. वन शुड नो दैट मेकोंग गंगा कोऑपरेशन is simply related to cooperation in these four areas. To have better people-to-people contact, to have more and more cultural integration. For that purpose, this platform is created. So it is incorrect statement. It comprises all the member countries of ASEAN. This is not correct. ASEAN is having 10 members. Total, there are 10 members. But Mekong Ganga cooperation is 5+1. One is India and 5 ASEAN countries. Not all ASEAN countries are the members. So simply we can eliminate this. The chairmanship of Mekong Ganga cooperation is rotated in alphabetical order. Many of the regional organizations are having this strategy. Alphabetical order mein wo kya karta hai? Rotate karta hai. For example, BRICS. Similar way mein, BRICS mein bhi jo chairmanship hota hai, presidentialship, ye अल्फाबेटिकली चेंज होते रहता है. ठीक है, शिफ्ट होता है. सो दिस इज करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट एंड दैट्स वाई वन, ओनली वन इज द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. ठीक है, फाइन, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट नेक्स्ट. ओके, दिस इज द न्यू वे ऑफ फ्रेमिंग क्वेश्चंस. दिस यूपीएससी हैज अडॉप्टेड दिस ईयर, राइट? सो स्टेटमेंट वन एंड स्टेटमेंट टू, फ्लाई ऐश. So every year UPC asks minimum one or two MCQs related to pollutants, and already I have discussed how they are asking question. They are largely focusing on the sources of pollutants, characteristics of pollutants, impact on the health and environment, and what are the government measures and international initiatives to deal with these pollutants. Fly ash is one such, we can say, pollutant, but it is also having some positive use, or we can say benefits. What are these? We'll try to understand. Fly ash is a byproduct of thermal power plants and is harmful for the soil health. Now this is not correct. Second part. First part is correct. It is byproduct of thermal power plants, and this fly ash is rather beneficial for soil health. How it is? It is beneficial. It makes soil more porous. It increases water holding capacity of soil. It maintains the pH of soil. So we can say that it benefits the soil, not harmful. And we got that first statement is incorrect. Simply we got the correct answer here. Kaise? One incorrect hone wala ek hi option hai. We got the answer without reading the second statement. Nitrogen is absent in the fly ash. Humne abhi presume kar liya hai aur wo sahi hai. Statement 2 is correct. Rather, fly ash composition, it is comprised of oxides of silicon, iron, aluminium. So it is not having nitrogen as its component. So second statement is correct here. That's why D is the correct answer. Now we are also aware the other benefits of fly ash or use application. Fly ash is used in the construction. It can be used as a construction material, as a filler in cement roads. And National Highway Authority of India has also made compulsion of use of this fly ash in constructing roads within 100 km radius of thermal power plants. ठीक है, ये भी आप additional information याद रखिए. D is the correct answer, right? Okay. Talking about next question talks about salt manufacturing in India, salt production. So India is the third largest salt manufacturing country in the world. Factually, this is correct. USA and China, first two, and India is third largest. But you can see that we are salt loving people, although it is harmful for health. ठीक है, हमारे health के लिए salt बहुत सही नहीं है. ठीक है, BP के patients के लिए तो और problematic है. So simply one should know that in India the salt production is high, although it is consumed largely within the country and less amount is exported. Now the production of salt from the inland salt lakes exceeds the salt production from the coastal salt plants. Okay, now what about this statement? The production of salt from inland salt lakes exceeds the salt production from the coastal. आप logic use करिए यहाँ पर. ज़्यादातर राजस्थान के जो लेक्स है, बहुत ज्यादा सॉल्ट प्रोडक्शन वहीं से होता है पूरे कंट्री में. ठीक है, सो कैन वी से दैट दिस इज करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट? यस. यस, सो although Rajasthan is the leading producer, but we know that the coastal areas, we have long coastline and there the salt production is more, and we can say it is incorrect. Rather, salt production in coastal salt plants is more than the inland. So we can say it is incorrect. First one is correct. The public sector leads in the production of salt in the country. It used to lead during the time period of independence, yeah, kuch saal उसके बाद भी, but at present the private sector, Tata नमक सबको पता है ना, तो basically now the private sector is leading the salt production. We can say it is incorrect and that's why answer is one only. ठीक है, right? Let's talk about the next. Right to privacy. Okay, so right to privacy under Article 21 is also applicable to the prisoners and convicts. This is correct. Right to let's say right to privacy is part of right to life with dignity under Article 21, and it is most important fundamental right, we can say, that the person is having, and even state cannot take away that. Puttaswamy's judgment 2017 has again highlighted right to privacy as a part of Article 21. Now, yes, it is applicable to prisoners as well as convicts. They are also people, no? They are also people, they are also human, and right to privacy is inherent to human. Right to privacy is inherent to human. So we can say that this is correct statement. Right to healthy environment is construed as the part of right to life under Article 21. This is also correct. Healthy environment, although it is not explicitly mentioned, but it has been implicitly interpreted by Supreme Court in various judgments. जैसे हम दिल्ली के एयर पोल्यूशन वाले जो जजमेंट्स होते हैं, तो वहाँ पे हेल्दी एनवायरमेंट के लिए राइट आर्टिकल 21 इज कंसिडर्ड बाय दीज कोर्ट्स. Now, CCTV cameras are not allowed in the prisons to maintain the privacy of inmates. So, yes, one can say this is correct. CCTV cameras are not there is no compulsion in the prisons to, we can say, have CCTV cameras, and that's why all three statements are correct here. Right? Okay. Okay, so description of a personality. Recently we had celebrated the birth anniversary of one personality, historical personality, and this description is related to that personality. He was born in the village Nagwa in Balia district of Uttar Pradesh. He served as a sepoy in 34th Bengal Native Infantry Regiment of British East India Company. He shot at Sergeant Adjutant Major's Lieutenant Henry Bogg, which is referred as the first gun fired on an Englishman. He was. Okay, so the person described here is Mangal Pandey. Famous movie, Bollywood movie, is also there on the personality, life of this person. Mangal Pandey, he was an important person during revolt of 1857. Right? So related to that also, in detail information about Mangal Pandey is given in the explanation, and the explanation PDF is attached to this video in the description of this video. You can read it later on. Now, next question. Again, description, but here not of personality but a protected area that was in news. It is an important wildlife sanctuary in the news for highly endangered Bengal floricon, black species ke naam diye gaye hai, and it is also home to great Indian one horned rhinos, tiger, leopard. One horned rhinos hoga to zyada tar kahan pe hoga wo? Either West Bengal ya fir Assam. Right, here the grassland is also rich in various kinds of medicinal herbs. Several wetlands within the wildlife sanctuary make it ideal breeding place for several species migratory birds during winter season. Okay, so this particular wildlife sanctuary, Bura Chapuri Wildlife Sanctuary, was recently in news. This is on the southern bank of Brahmaputra River, located on Brahmaputra River in Assam. Theek hai, it was in news. So those protected areas, generally sanctuaries puchta nahi hai UPSC, bahut hi unique specific agar ho quality characteristics या यूनिक स्पेसीज के लिए वो वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी बनाया हो तभी वो पूछता है. अदरवाइज नेशनल पार्क्स, टाइगर रिजर्व्स एंड वी कैन से बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स, दे आर मोर इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर आवर एग्जामिनेशन. ठीक है, ओके. बेपी कोलंबो मिशन, यस इट वाज इन न्यूज रिसेंटली. बेपी कोलंबो मिशन इज जॉइंट मिशन बाय यूरोप एंड जापानीज agencies to Mercury planet. This is correct, and recently it has given some explanation to, we can say, that the electron auroras that are found there, right? And these auroras, how they are formed, that is being explained there. It is the first mission to send two spacecraft to make complementary measurements of Mercury and its environment at the same time. This is correct. It uses combination of solar electric propulsion and gravity assist flybys. What is this? Electric propulsion, solar electric propulsion means it is using the solar energy, and gravity assist flybys means it is using the gravity of these planets to change the direction and provide some thrust. Theek hai, so this is also correct statement. All three statements are correct here, right? Okay. ये देखिए, सॉरी मैंने इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑरोराज बोला है, एक्सरे ऑरोराज है, पार्डन मी. सो इट इज टॉकिंग एक्सप्लेनिंग द एक्सरे ऑरोराज ऑब्जर्व इन द एनवायरमेंट ऑफ मर्क्यूरी. प्रधानमंत्री मित्र स्कीम, ओके, अर्लियर ऑल्सो वी हैड डिस्कस्ड वन एमसीक्यू ऑन दिस. प्रधानमंत्री मित्र स्कीम, मित्रा पार्क्स आर बींग एस्टेब्लिश्ड एज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चरल पार्क्स or textile industry.
ओके इट इज़ बाय टेक्सटाइल मिनिस्ट्री. ठीक है, तो लेट्स सी, इट एम्स टू क्रिएट इंटीग्रेटेड टेक्सटाइल वैल्यू चेन. दिस इज करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. द स्कीम इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री. नॉट करेक्ट, देयर इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टेक्सटाइल्स सेपरेटली. दिस इज इनकरेक्ट. अंडर द प्रोजेक्ट पीएम मित्र पार्क्स विल बी एस्टैब्लिश एज अ स्पेशल पर्पज व्हीकल कंप्लीटली ओन्ड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. नाउ दिस इज नॉट करेक्ट. रादर देर विल बी PPP projects by both center and state with the private sector, public-private partnership. So it is incorrect, and that's why only one statement is correct here. Okay, let's talk about ninth statement now about enforcement directorate. Okay, so enforcement directorate was created as a separate attached unit to we can say that Ministry of Finance in 1950s. But later on it was renamed as Enforcement Directorate, and as a part of Department of Revenue in Ministry of Finance it is attached to that. So Ministry of Home Affairs nahi hai, incorrect hai. And yes, it deals with the financial crimes, financial frauds, and we can say that it has been provided the functions under some of the statutes like FEMA Act, Foreign Exchange Management Act is there. Then we have Serious Frauds Economic Fraud and Economic Offences Act 2018 का जो है उसके अंडर, और मेजर जो हम बोलते हैं PMLA, राइट. सो मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग प्रिवेंशन ऑफ मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग एक्ट 2002 PMLA 2002, और फेरा जो है उसके पहले का एक्सचेंज रेगुलेशन एक्ट वाला. सो वॉट एवर द फंक्शंस अंडर दीज provisions are there, enforcement of provisions of these laws is responsibility of ED, Enforcement Director. बहुत बार अभी news में है, बहुत सारे ministers और civil servants के against ED ने action लिया हुआ है, and that's why it is always in news. It is responsible for investing offences, money laundering under this. So this is correct, first one is incorrect, that's why answer is B. The last MCQ for today. Okay, so this Rostov place was in news recently because the Ukrainian forces are attacking this place in Russia. That's why it was in news. Mapping section se ek dusra type ka humne question tayar karne ki koshish ki hai. Right, if one has to travel via the shortest sea route from Athens, Greece to Rostov, Russia, which of the following prominent water bodies and straits he or she will have to cross? Earlier, UPC used to ask such kind of question. Before 2010-11 we can say, mapping section से. Now we are aware that Athens, Greece के right side में जब हम देखते हैं, और eastern side से वहाँ से हम जब enter करेंगे Aegean Sea आएगा, there after Sea of Marmara is there, there after we enter into Black Sea, ठीक है, Sea of Marmara, Black Sea, there after we cross the Kerch Strait, which was again, it was in news, जो Ukraine ने वहाँ का ब्रिज जो है वो तोड़ा है रिसेंटली, राइट. रशिया हैज अलीग्ड दैट द ब्रिज कनेक्टिंग टू वी क्रीमिया रीजन थ्रू कर्च स्ट्रेट वॉज ब्रोकन, और वी कैन से डिस्ट्रॉयड. और यहाँ से क्रॉस करके कौन सा सी आता है? सी ऑफ अजोव. ओके, एंड देयर वी रीच देयर आफ्टर रोस्तोव. तो सी ऑफ अजोव भी होता तो वो भी इसका पार्ट होता. Now, Ionian Sea is on the western side of, we can say that, this Athens. So, Athens se Rostov jate vakt jo hai, wo raste mein nahi girega. So, it is not part, and that's why 2, 3, 4, that is B is the correct answer. Fine? Okay. So, I hope that these sessions are benefiting you. Yahan pe map pe dekh lijiye ek bar. Theek hai? कहाँ चला गया? हाँ, ब्लैक सी. ओके, दिस इज ग्रीस एंड एथेंस विल बी समवेयर हियर. एजियन सी, सी ऑफ मारमारा, ब्लैक सी हियर, स्ट्रेट कर्च स्ट्रेट, सी ऑफ अजोव, दिस इज रोस्तोव. इस तरीके से आएगा, ठीक है. और आयोनियन सी इस साइड में आएगा, ठीक है. ओके, सो दीज आर टुडेज 10 MCQs. फाइन. ओके, लेट अस स्टॉप देन. थैंक यू.